Hello, and welcome to the team building presentation. The agenda will be to meet the quality leadership team, the team's purpose, the team's strengths and weaknesses, critique the team effectiveness, the team leadership theory model, team building activities, and conclusion. This is the Quality and Safety Committee team. It was unclear of which type of leadership that each member was, and therefore, each member will be considered as a servant leader for this presentation. Okay, so the team's purpose is to promote patient safety and deliver high quality nursing care. Its aim is to improve patient care quality. Be as servant leaders and nursing support for all departments. And this team was formed to address internal and external teamwork issues. Internal and external problems. Limited teamwork, especially among external environments within the nursing departments. Limited attributes as servant leaders to resolve teamwork problems. Lack of teamwork plan and concept in the workplace. And delayed initiative by team leadership to address the problem. Team strengths. The team has strong organizational ethics. It respects organizational culture. It upholds the mission of the organization. And the team members share the same beliefs and values. Team composition. The team is composed of administrative and managerial personnel. And it is multicultural. And all the members are servant leaders. However, the team has its weaknesses. In communication etiquette, it is inconsistent with follow-up among its team members. It has limited discussions on nursing quality issues, and it lacked communication of its external existence to nursing staff. The weaknesses in its management strategies are the nature of the problem conflicts with the team purposes. The team has a lack of internal and external team feedback. And it has delayed initiative to address issues such as teamwork, morale, support, that is considered a major issue. Critique team effectiveness. The team has reviewed its major team accountabilities of patient safety in delivering high quality care. It has emphasis on improving patient care, such as satisfaction and care delivery. However, nurses had addressed teamwork issues of other nurses that decreased patient care quality to external leadership, that they did not know that this team had existed prior to the addressed issues. continued critique of team's effectiveness. External leadership informed internal leadership, a team of issues in nursing care. The concerned nurses were unaware of a quality and safety leadership committee that prompted external leadership to inform the internal leadership team to communicate its existence to the nurses. Moreover, this team had placed more emphasis on external teamwork performance evaluations, anticipating improved teamwork and patient care, than on internal evaluations. During the time of evaluating this team, only external job performance evaluations existed. External evaluations included teamwork indicators from minimal to maximal measures that only included either a yes or no option without indicating quantitative rationale for behavior of the staff. For supportive needs of a performance evaluation, evidence has shown that performance evaluations or reward systems only become effective if cardinal beliefs of human nature as being mainly instrumental, calculative, and rationale is accurate. And instrumentality neglects humans' emotional nature. And therefore, evaluations need to be performed on both internal and external team members. And this team should be as a role model to the external team. The team as servant leaders. Clustered data has stated robust predictors of servant leadership, effective trust, organizational behaviors, and followers' task performance. Effective trust fully demonstrated servant leadership's effect on job performance, while partially demonstrated servant leadership's effect on followers' behaviors. Cognitive trust, which is based on competence and others' capabilities, did not demonstrate servant leadership's effect on behavior or job performance. However, associated affective trust, which is based on feelings about others' behaviors, was a significant factor of servant leadership's positive individual performance. In addition, findings indicated that servant leadership is studied globally, evaluated by various instruments, linked to positive organizational, individual, and team outcomes. Also, servant leadership was positively related to job engagement, organizational and innovative behaviors, organizational commitment, trust, self-efficacy, person organizational fit, leader member exchange, and work-life balance. Also, it was negatively associated with burnout and turnover. Therefore, as servant leaders, the team members within this leadership team should communicate to their external followers as the nurses to address team work issues. And also, they should communicate to the external leadership in regards to teamwork issues. And finally, communication to internal and external team members is an essential attribute as a servant leader for obtaining feedback on team effectiveness. The team leadership model. The HEAL model prompts leadership decisions as to whether they monitor or act based upon internal or external factors. To focus on the overall team effectiveness, the team leader should assess the situation that the team is experiencing and assess components of the problem. And then the leader must seek information to understand the current state of the team's functioning. This information must be interpreted so the leader can decide how to act. Then the leader will continue to monitor. If there is a weakness in the team, the leader will then act on that weakness. The interventions guided by the HEAL model will begin with the chief nursing officer, followed by a nurse executive, a nurse director, a human resource director, and a quality coordinator director. The provided interventions will be to network and inform alliances in external environment, negotiate with upper leaders for support and resources, and assess environmental indicators for team effectiveness. The chief nursing officer will then interact and form external relationships, negotiate with upper leaders to secure resources or use alternative goals, and extract external data for team effectiveness, such as nurses' feedback of team leaders' effectiveness of improving teamwork, or feedback from external leadership. The nurse executive would then assist in networking with nurse directors in the external environment and also advocate to represent the team in their external environment. Guided by the model, the nurse executive should connect and form relationships with nursing directors and establish widespread newsletters to external environment that state internal team's efforts to meet goals. The nurse director would then share relevant information to external and external environments and modeling ethical practices within the team and to external environment, such as reviewing both internal and external environments to assess organization's new direction in improving teamwork, and share importance of being role models for the external environment to maintain consistency in teamwork practices, which should be enforced by each member of the team. Guided by the HEAL model, the human resource director should collaborate with internal team and decrease team leaders' environmental distractions, such as collaborating with team to compromise on effective external and internal performance evaluations and feedback, and facilitate team members' focus on goals to maintain exposure and feedback strategies. this human resource director would be a significant support and a resource for the internal team and an external team, and assist us with modifying the evaluations for internal and external leadership. The final two interventions guided by the HEAL model will be performed by the Quality Care Coordinator Director, who will structure the results and facilitate goal focus, such as guiding a team to plan and delegate to external environment to improve teamwork that in turn should improve quality of care, and discuss plans to maintain internal team integrity, including maintaining goals to improve internal and external teamwork. Now, after the shared interventions of the HEAL model has been completed, it is time for the team to create an activity that will build up the team. Since this team has no internal evaluation, the human resource director will assist in forming this evaluation that will consist of electronic, external organization leader meetings and feedback, and electronic staff nurse surveys. That will also include a section for nurses to type in opportunities for improvement that will be submitted to external leadership within the organization. The human resource director should then assist in modifying the existing external evaluation by revision of current staff evaluation, placing more emphasis on teamwork that will be reviewed by the nurse manager. A summary of the evidence. Evidence has shown that effective behaviors and concepts related to teamwork can improve employees' performances, productivity, ability to resolve conflicts, and unexpected challenges. Performance appraisals and rewards were considered as positive, essential factors of employee performance. Also, performance evaluations and bonuses are effective tools for improving employee performance. Employee motivation of goal setting and feedback were more effective than other emotional factors. Conclusion. The Quality and Safety Committee leadership team was composed of upper-level leaders as Chief Nursing Officer, Nurse Executive, Nurse Director, Human Resources Director, and a Quality Care Coordinator Director. The team's upper leadership worked with lower-level leadership within the team. However, this team should follow evidence-based teamwork practices to benefit organization and its internal and external team leaderships. And thank you for your time.